Hello and welcome to a tutorial for Maya. It's been a long time since I made a tutorial, so I'm really excited to show you something after all this time. This tutorial is actually very specific in the topic, and it's actually aimed a bit more towards intermediate or advanced riggers that already have a rig setup going, and it's just going to show a little technique that I've used to extend the functionality of a specific body part. In this case, it's the legs, right? So if you look at this character, it's actually a biped character, but it has very quadruped style leg going, right? So what we want to do here is add the functionality to have these legs, which are currently rigged with a biped solution, to work for this quadruped scenario. Okay. A quick rundown of this setup here, let me quickly. You can see the underlying anatomy here. So we have a thigh bone, we have a knee bone, and then the ankle bone goes, it's this long third leg piece here, and then the toe bones and the ball is planted on the ground down here. And so if I were to rotate this, like move it down there, rotate this up, get the toes to be straight again, you can see, oh, it's a weird leg, but this is basically the anatomy of a human leg, right? So we have two main leg segments, then we have this first long foot segment, and then the toes coming out of that, as a very, very, very basic description. And for a quadruped, it's actually the exact same setup and layout, with the difference that the first foot segment is also part of the leg chain, right? So it's only the toes and the ball at the ball position planted on the ground, okay? But since this has been rigged with a biped, you can see that my control pivot is at the ankle and I can move this. And this foot actually from the ankle down will remain static and FKE, and this is all I can do, right? So while this might work for humans, we need a little bit of, or we could actually use a bit more functionality for this rather quadrupedy leg, okay? So, because if I move this leg back and forward, you can see it would be cool if this control would, you know, rotate automatically to adapt for this position, you know, so that we'd have a little bit less to animate. And this is what we're going to implement here. It's a function that allows for this segment of the leg to automatically adapt to its position. And rotate this automatically. Okay. There is two prerequisites that we actually need for this system to work. I'm going to show it to you now. So the first obviously is a control like this. So if you have a IK foot rig system, pretty sure you will have implemented some system to roll the ball like that, right? It can be a control additionally like this, it can be an attribute here like this roll attribute, or something along those lines, right? But you have to have a functionality like this that we can then connect into, right? Because we will add something to these values that will also drive this thing. And the second functionality is a pivot, moving functionality. So you can see here on this foot control, I have the pivot attribute. If I make this visible, it actually has this, it shows this locator here that I can move anywhere in the scene. And you can see the pivot for my foot control is now wherever this locator is at, right? And so the idea is that we have this locator where we can move this pivot onto the ball joint there, right? So now we have our control pivot down here, where it's a little bit more intuitive because this is like the planted on the ground height, right? So now we can move this guy from here. It basically behaves the same after all, so all at the top is still static. But now we can rotate like this as well, and you know, to get that kind of effect going. Okay, so from here is where we want to start. Let's hide the model for a while, show the joints, and get started. So the first thing that we want to do is get a copy of the leg chain and duplicate, let's duplicate that. So I duplicate that and move out of my hierarchy to have a cleaner look. Let's delete all the unnecessary nodes and make it three bone chains. So we can delete the ball joints here, right? So all we're left with is this, right? Thigh, knee, ankle. That's all we want for this additional joint chain, okay? I'm gonna get quickly give it a name. Let's do that. Right, so I want to suffix this with QPD, and the prefix should be JDRV because it's not a a binding joint. We will not bind skin to this. This is just an auxiliary joint to help us with the maths, which by the way is going to be taken care of entirely in the rig with some constraints in IK, so no need to do maths. But the underlying idea is just basic trigonometry. Okay, so with this chain, we want to adjust this a little bit. We can't have it like this. So the idea is that the total length of this chain equals the total length of the full leg chain up to the ball joint, such that when the IK is fully stretched, this chain will also be fully stretched. Okay. Now we just need to figure out how to distribute the lengths, and that is actually dictated quite straightforward. So we want the first segment of the chain to be of the length of our ankle, of this bone here. So I can select my ankle bone, this can select the one in the rig. I can get the down arrow to get me the translate value of this, which is actually also the length. And I'm gonna plug it into the knee joint here, right? So now our knee joint has the length of our ankle length, and for this joint here, all we have to do is get the combined length of the upper and lower leg from the original chains. So what I can do here is to select the leg, go to the knee joint, copy me the translate value, put it in the command line, get down arrow again to get me to the ankle, copy that value, put it in the command line with a plus. The result is shown here. I can then select the first nine as well, or just select everything. Maya will just round it and connect it here. Whoops, not there, here. Okay, so now we have this going, actually wrong way around. This length here, I swapped actually the lengths of these bones. This guy here needs to get that value, and this guy here needs to get that value. Okay, that's much better. Good. So this is the kind of look that we want to have. And now what we need is to have this point, you know, be at this ball place there. So we can use a quick temporary IK to get that going from the thigh to the end bone, snap the IK handle to there. I'm just gonna quickly use the this IK here to drive me a pole vector to basically snap this a little bit such that it's a bit better aligned with the general leg plane. Now we can delete this IK and quickly freeze transformations on this joint. And let's quickly control that the orientations on this knee are fine, which they are. Sorry. So now we can continue. We continue by doing actually a new IK. Wait, wrong. There we go. And let's quickly drive this with a poll vector again. Right, so we needed the first IK to just put it in place, and we freeze transformations to get the clean rotation channels from this guy, and then we can run the IK again to to have to get the behavior that we want. Okay, so what we want to do now is to control this IK handle with this control, right? And here's a quick thing that I want to add as a precaution. We will use a parent constraint. Now, the problem with parent constraints is that they will look at your driver's pivot to determine the output positions. And since this control has this pivot node here, which I can move a con locator to a tweak its pivot, it would basically propagate down to all the constraints that this thing is outputting and modifying those whenever I modify the pivot, which I don't want. So what I did is I added an additional locator down here, right below the control hierarchy. And this is called constraint node. So what it does is this locator is actually outputting all the constraints that this lag control has. And it will also do with this current one. So I will select this constraint node, select this IK handle, constraint parent. Right, and now you can see this chain that we now made is following, but my pivot is still unharmed, and I can still, you know, do pivoty stuff without actually damaging the constraint. Okay. So what's up next? Let's quickly make a group for this guy because, you know, the base is still uncontrolled. So if I move the something like the heap, you can see this chain is still actually where it's at. So we need to change that. So what I will just do is I will get this group and put it with the other joints here. Right. So basically this is my bind joints, my FK, my IK chains, my target length chains, and this is basically all the joints for this general leg setup, which is under this group, which are driven by the spine A joint. Therefore, now this thing, you can see now the chain is actually following properly. Okay. We can quickly get the IK. I'm not naming these things now for the video, but you know, general practice name things, but I'm not gonna tell this to my target audience because you should know that. And I will parent that into the rig group for this module, which holds like all the non-bone or non-control nodes, like IKs and intermediate locators and whatnot. Okay, so now that we have this, you can see it's basically already like doing, like behaving in an interesting way. So what we want to do now is to output the rotation of this guy into this control. So to do that, I'm gonna hit up arrow until I go to this point here, which is basically where the roll attribute from here plugs in. I will open up my node editor. We can see this is the multiply node, this is the rotate. And here in between, we want to plug the thing in. So what I will add is a plus minus average node and connect the output to this, get me this bone, get the rotate Y connected to the second slot, and I think we already have a system that works now. Or actually not. What did I actually connect this to? Ah, yes. Make sure to connect the output. Okay, so now we can see how this chain is behaving, and you probably see a little bit better if I show the model. So now you can see all I have to do is move my IK, my control, which is down here, and you can see the ankle is automatically aligning to that position. Unlike with the other legs, so you can see if I move this here, you can see this is looking much nicer than on this side here, where the ankle is just completely static and oblivious to the movement of the rest of the body, which is very, very unnatural. So we're fixing that with the setup. Okay, so one last thing that I want to add is a switch to turn this feature off, because I'm pretty sure some animators would rather, just animate these things by hand, and not having to counter animate whatever I made here. So to do that, let's just quickly add an attribute. Let's call this auto rotate. Have this go from 0 to 1. Add the control to the graph. Okay, delete this connection because we want to make another connection first. So we're gonna use the mult double linear, which basically just multiplies two values together. And the first one is our rotate Y. The second one is our auto rotate. And then the output here goes into this thing. Okay. So now we can move this thing. You can see nothing happens until we move this, we turn this value to on, and you can softly blend between this feature in and out. So you could have like 50% if you wanted, or whatever value you wanted in between. Right, that's pretty much it. So yeah, I think that's it. If you have any questions, let me know how you like this video and if it actually helped you or not. And maybe see you soon for something else. Thanks for stopping by. Bye.